It's time for Baratier!
No!
God, I hate that we had to wait, but we're back. It's day two of the One Piece live action, and they reveal Garp as Luffy's grandpa. I'm rough.
I'm Boom.
I was not ready for that either.
No, I was like not either.
Oh. Oh, I.
Hoist the oar. Batten down the hatches. Raise the mizzenmast.
No way. We about to get Luffy Garp backstory already.
I hope.
I was.
Punch of love.
Grandpa, it's my first ship.
How do you expect to be a Marine when you're wasting your time on this nonsense?
I don't want to be.
Damn. Marine. Unsupportive.
I'm a pirate. Grandpa, don't! Stop! It's my ship!
Yo, Garp and his villain arc in this, bro.
He ripped up his flag.
Your training begins today.
Oh, what?
Punch.
Yo, I ain't gonna lie. If you don't know anything about the manga or the anime, you think Garp is 100% a villain.
Like, so, dude, right? All right. Yeah, and that's the point I actually want to bring
up
here.
I
wonder.
Think about it, though, right? In this world, right? Pirates are bad. Marines are good. He's a vice admiral. That. Like, he's a vice admiral, and his grandson is like, I want to be a pirate. Stabbed himself in the eye already.
That's true.
Wearing the hat of a notorious pirate. Like, yo, imagine that shit.
It makes me wonder, they made that, because like having this appear here in this part of the story, right?
Mm-hmm.
To me, kind of, I understand why they're doing it. Because just knowing that he's going into a training arc with Garp as a kid explains why Luffy has his combat prowess in the earlier videos that we've seen so far.
I think it's that.
You know, and I think,
to be honest, and I might be wrong, I think this mostly stems from them not knowing if they're going to get a second season. Because at the end of the day, right, what is the goal of this? This is to get new people into One Piece. And
100%.
What is a bigger bomb drop than fucking the vice admiral of the Marines is the main character's grandpa? You know what I mean? Like, it's such an interesting dynamic that, like, I feel like including that in that first season might get people to be like, all right, I need to know
I'm
what
invested.
Happens. Come on.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because, like,
invested.
You know, thinking about normal One Piece, it's mostly, you know, a lot of mystery of, oh, who's that character? Oh, who's that character? And then it's like the excitement of we're going to the Grand Line. But that's really it, right? Because then you just get right into the Grand Line, where we know it's going to be years before we get a season two. Especially with the strike going on. So,
God, yeah. It
right?
Be a while.
So, like, this is such a good way, I feel like, to give more of the story early on to really, like, get the hooks in, you know?
Well, also, he's the strongest Marine we've seen so far, right?
Yes. Yeah, I mean, we've only really seen Morgan.
Like, I'm just trying to, like, look at it from, like, a new person approaching this series, right? And seeing Garp as the top dog in the Marines as of right now is what
we've seen
so far, right? And for them to basically announce that it's his grandson, and now we're seeing him going on a training arc.
Yeah, it's a big deal.
It's a huge deal. Like, it's a very huge deal at this point in the story, like, knowing that. So, I like it. I like this placement, honestly.
Fire back at them!
Or how about we sail away as fast as we can?
Run from the Marines?
No, never.
Nami, trim the sail thing. Let's sink their ship.
Bro, they ride in like a metal boat.
You know what a loaded cannon, right?
Yeah, of course, I loaded thousands of them. This must be a different model than I'm used to.
Which is
load the cannon in the barrel, light the fuse, and get the
oh god, I love this.
This is
Oh no. This is amazing.
Oh man.
He's like, this is rough.
Oh my god.
Fire vessel by order of the Marines.
Oh, it's so sick.
Oh! Oh, I'm a beast. Oh! Oh!
He's
here we go!
It.
Oh, we getting it!
We gotta do it! Let's go! Hell yes! Oh my god!
I didn't know if they were gonna do it!
I was hoping.
Oh. Kobe saves El Meppo? Okay.
Only a family member can piss you off that much.
Yeah. Right?
Not bad, boy.
I love that he's got a little pride in it.
I know.
Tell me you could do that. I didn't know I could.
I love that it's just like the idea. He like imagined it and it was like, whoo. Bro, see.
Oh, wait.
Okay.
Dude.
All right.
Oh, okay.
I like it.
Let's go, all right. Dude.
Bro, all right. So
the peg leg too.
So I really didn't know. I didn't know if we were gonna him throwing the cannonball. But I love that we had that extended like discussion of Sione being like, he's the strongest Marine ever. And I was just like,
yeah.
Fuck, I'm trying to shut my goddamn mouth. He's like, well, yeah, shit. Man, throwing goddamn cannonballs.
Well, I mean, remember there was the scene early on too where it's like Usopp was like, I've never fired a cannon before. And he like had like a dead shot onto like Johnny and Yusuke in the end. And I guess we're not really going to get that now because
I think we will. I think that each one of them
that
is
was
going
kind of that scene. Like yeah, they kind of replaced those scenes together.
I think that each Straw Hat's going to get like one
their moment
before the end, whether it's like Usopp hitting a shot as the sniper or like, you know, the future characters, whatever. Like, I think they're all going to have like their own dedicated moment to really solidify like this, the squad. Get excited.
Can you go back? Like, I swear it looked like when they were going into like that storm, there was like something there on the top left. I'm probably just crazy though.
And it's just cloud.
Okay.
God, I think this is my favorite one so far though. I like this one a lot.
Yeah.
Especially because like it looks like plates.
I like the Zoro one. Of course, I was called a Zoro tard in the comments, so.
Can't see the Marines.
About this and that other thing.
What other thing?
Oh, gee, I wonder. The Vice Admiral of the Marines is my grandfather thing?
Ooh, that. Yeah, I don't really know the guy that well.
It doesn't seem like a big deal.
You're his first mate. Kind of seems like that falls under your job description.
I like that she's acknowledging him as the first mate.
Fine. About the battle, you want to talk about it?
Nope.
Okay, good talk.
There's something on the breeze. It smells like butter.
Sniff it out.
There's someone somewhere cooking.
That's... Yeah.
I love him just chilling on the
5 degrees starboard. No.
Oh, now he knows directions.
All it took was the food.
Suddenly he knows how to navigate.
What is that?
Dude, this music right now. Let's go.
Ratier.
Ha. Now nobody can give me shit for calling it Baratier. Dude, I cannot tell you how many times I will get corrected about the way that they say that word.
Oh yeah, it's
every time I say it, every single time I say it. Yeah, like I don't know why. Well, fuck you. Now they confirmed it. Oh my god, it looks so cool.
Oh, that's sick, dude.
So they got a little outdoor seating. Okay.
God, I love the design, dude.
Welcome to Baratie.
Oh my god, Captain Usopp coming in hot.
Perhaps you've heard of him. Well, in that case, we'll find a table.
Yeah, I knew it!
In 3 weeks.
You'll have to excuse them. They're idiots.
Of course. Right this way, ma'am. See? Works every time.
And they think that it worked.
Jesus Christ, I...
I'd be happy to check your swords for you, sir.
I got this.
Very good. Here are your menus. Your waiter will be with you shortly.
I wouldn't hand my swords over to nobody either.
Nope. Nah, not on the seas like this.
Mm-mm.
Sheesh.
Wow. Damn.
If I gotta sling one more prime rib medium well, I am going to drop dead of boredom, you old shit.
That is what we say.
Insult.
No, you don't like that. You're fine. Because I'll be more than delighted to give you some other work elsewhere. In fact, you are off the line. Now get out there on my tables. Move.
I'm saying this.
Bro, I love that. I don't know if you guys saw it, but I didn't watch the clip because right before, I think it was the day after or the day before this came out, they released, I'm assuming, that scene between Sanji and Zeff.
Oh, no,
I didn't watch it because I wanted to wait because I was like, it's a day, like, fuck it. But I saw so many people that were on edge about the live action that scene, they were like, all right, you got me.
Yeah, no, if we didn't react to it, I didn't watch it because I didn't want to get, like, spoiled outside of anything just in case.
All the way around. This is awesome. Like, this is such a great scene between them two.
Close to the kitchen. So I can smell the beef.
Maybe you ought to try a table outside. Right now, the only thing I smell is you.
Oh, it's full body.
Now, gentlemen. After he apologizes for his bad manners.
Over my dead body.
Oh! Oh!
Now, I will say, side note, I do follow, like, the cast on Instagram. Uh-huh. And, like, he can actually do that. Like,
oh,
like,
really?
He posts, like, videos of his, like, training. Uh-huh. Dude's insane.
Yeah. Huh.
No, like, no, he's fucking, like, he's fucking
the food
nuts.
Plate, dude.
I want to watch it again.
He even kept the food on the plate. Watch, dude.
Oh, that was with a back leg.
Bro.
Good fight. Please, enjoy your meals.
He just left them there, dude.
Perhaps you'd like a glass of umeshu. You know, something sweet for someone sweet.
Something wrong with your eye?
Just blinded by your beauty.
Waiter, can I
get
Yo, the riz, though!
No matter.
Water.
Still sparkling mineral with ice or without, cubed or crushed?
Damn.
Regular water in a regular glass. Thanks.
Right away.
Nothing. Madam, forgive my rude behavior. Madam, would madam prefer her water in a crystal glass or would a golden bowl be more madam style?
Nami's got a boyfriend.
You guys are the worst.
But you like them, though.
If we delay, we might lose track of Luffy entirely.
No SOS calls. We'll handle this problem on our own.
Garp said, I ain't no bitch.
Right? I don't need help. I'm not gonna let this little shit outsmart me.
Hello? Did I catch you in the middle of something?
Oh! Oh! Let's...
Bounty canceled! Oh!
Just killing some time. What can I do for you, Vice Admiral?
I have a request for you.
Oh, this is awesome.
Suit your particular talents.
Who's the quarry?
Oh,
holy
bro, and them going flying.
Fancies himself a pirate.
This is how they're gonna do it. And that's Creek's ship in the background.
One moment.
Oh, do it. Do it. Yes.
No.
Yes. Oh, what?
No.
Yo, dude.
The fact that they're even showing
Oh, my God, the Wilhelm scream.
Oh, my.
Like, right at the end.
That's amazing.
Oh, he is in it.
Please kill him right here. Please. Do it here. Fuck this guy so much.
Why are you after me?
You woke me from my nap.
Yes.
Then allow me to make you permanent.
Oh, that's so... Dude. I'm gonna need a cigarette after this scene. Oh,
Oh my god. Did the... I can't. He did. Oh, I love this man so much for getting rid of this dick bag. Like, fucking. Oh.
I. Bro. Wait. Oh.
So Mihawk is going to be the actual villain here? No Krieg at all. I'm excited, dude.
Bro, I'ma say it. I know we've been memeing with the titles. I like the since they have had Garp go after them, since Syrup Village, I prefer the way they're handling the story to the fucking original.
I'm not mad at it. I'm not mad at it. And like we all know, and like for those that are fans of the Monger Bros podcast, like we know how much I actively dislike Krieg as a character. Yeah. So, like, the fact that he's probably handled, like, even the absolute disrespect of, like, Mans didn't even get a death off camera or on camera. Like, it was, like, just a scream over the mic.
Yep.
It makes me so happy because fuck him so much.
I like the idea of, like, Garp getting involved, having that reveal, him sending Mihawk. Like, I don't know. Like, there's just something about it that I like a lot. Do you want uncut and early reactions to your favorite series that we do here on the channel?
What about double episodes?
We have all of that available and more for Billies on Patreon and members on YouTube.
Your support means the world to us, and it allows us to keep doing what we love and keep delivering you the content that you love or will eventually love, because Billy is love.
Billy is live.
Everything's gonna be fine, Billy.
Everything's gonna be fine, Billy.
Everything is gonna be fine, Billy. Everything is going to be fine, Billy.
Our very first battle and we crushed him.
I don't know how many naval battles you guys have been a part of.
24 at least.
But that was we were unprepared.
How are they?
He's gonna give him an IOU.
Thank you. I'm not saying it's good that the Marines are on our team.
I got a feeling he's going to be happy because somebody's going to get their ass beat.
Yeah.
Just roll over us. This crew, our crew, can handle anything.
Who the hell is Monkey Daniels?
Here, you seem here. To be confused about a rule. I think you're confused. The meal has already been paid for. I just haven't given you the money yet.
Yeah, and how's that?
You can add it to my treasure tab.
And what, pray tell, is that?
I may not look like a big deal yet. You're talking with the future king of the pirates.
Bro, Nami's just so fucking done.
Yep.
Dude, I would kill. Oh my god.
What?
Yo. He got 4 straws. I would kill to eat on a boat like this.
Pace yourself.
Take my money. I would love to do it.
Tastes just like candy. Last time I said that, I woke up face down under a table.
Bro, those sneaky drinks be hitting different.
I can't get caught, not when I'm so close.
There we go.
He's ready for my treat.
Favorite kind of drink.
That's how you know she's got that distraction when she's offering to pay for it.
You
drink for your friends too?
No. Just me.
Oh, the music change.
Be ready to sail at dawn.
I know I'm going to regret this, but what's wrong?
Hey, he's opening up.
I mean, somebody saves your life. I would hope it would. You would at least try to make some sort of small talk. I'm
starting to think you might be right about him.
What is it, my birthday? Of course I'm right.
Isn't this like a SBS or a cover story?
Right here? A lot of their stuff.
Like them mopping the floors and things. Like this whole scene right here.
It happened at, I think, the Marine base there. But yeah, like their bonding happened like during their training, I think.
Yeah, that's awesome. I'm just glad we're getting this scene, you know? Like,
well, that's the weird thing is like they are adding a lot of stuff that like I feel like most people wouldn't think about because they, like you said, they were cover stories or whatever.
Yeah. But it helps to tie the rest of the story together, you know?
To do the things they didn't want tied back to them. In exchange, the warlords were given free reign.
So do pirate stuff.
Dude.
Damn. Pirate stuff.
They are
I'm getting chills. I like this.
Like,
tie a knot, but you don't know shit about how the world works.
I didn't think about it.
I kind of appreciate this right now.
Yeah, damn, Helmeppo just kind of hitting him with some truth.
You think about it, though, it makes sense that he would know, right? Like, even though, his dad was, like, only a captain or whatever, but, like, he would be privy to, like, some knowledge that a normal cadet wouldn't know.
Well, I mean, I feel like anyone in the higher ranks would know about, like, the warlords.
Yeah.
It's...
Wow. It's a cook's paradise, and... I'm gonna find it one day. That's my dream.
If you want to cook, you should cook. Don't let some stubborn old man.
Oh, I like this dynamic.
Stand up to him. Tell him what you want.
He's like, you should have saw what I did to my grandfather earlier.
Right? Like...
Also, I looked it up just to be sure, but the bluefin tuna thing or whatever that he cooked is the fish that he won in the cooking contest.
See, like the small details, man.
Yeah, I thought I recognized the name or whatever. Yeah.
I love all the tiny details they've added. It's just been so good.
Oh, here we go. Oh, man, that means Krieg's gonna... probably still be alive.
I don't think so.
I hope not.
I think this is more like they're like, look, everybody hated Krieg, but everybody likes Gin, so we gotta include him still.
I'm so hungry. Please. Okay,
you got it, man. This like set up the morality of Sanji, like that you had to include this.
Mm-hmm.
Save yourself. Forget you ever heard of the One Piece.
He's a brother, sounds awesome. Oh my god.
Pretty sure there was alcohol in that drink.
I guess something about you, you drink. You guess something about me, I drink.
Dude, Zoro wins no matter what.
Right? Yeah. That's the point.
He drinks. Big city.
Running schemes.
Handful of houses in the center of a tangerine grove.
Oh, come on.
God damn it.
I'm waiting for that flashback, dude.
Mm-hmm.
I'll bet you didn't have any friends as a kid.
I had friends.
Swords don't count.
I had one friend.
Hell, one more than I had.
Should I come back later, sir?
No. I'm almost done here.
Bro, how many fucking steaks did he eat?
Is that three or four?
I could have been Fleet Admiral by now, but I always turned down the promotion. Do you know why? Because I'd have to do things their way. I'd lose my freedom. You understand?
Yes, sir.
The world is not fair. The Marines are all that are standing between order and anarchy. So, let me ask you, can you live with that?
This is a hell of a conversation, bro.
Yeah, bro, holy shit. I love the way they're handling this because they're being vague enough, but also, like, I love this, dude. Like, I told you guys, like, I saw, you know, like a ton of comments after, right? And I saw like a bunch of people that were like, oh, at the end of episode four, it all goes downhill, right? Last episode. And the second I read that, I was like, all right, well, one of two things is either going to happen. Either A, they're going to butcher the Baratie arc or butcher Arlong, or people are just going to start bitching because the end of episode four is with the grandpa stuff and now they're changing the story and people are going to riot. And I think it's pretty much clear as day at this point. It's just because they changed stuff and people are mad. It's not one to one. We've talked about this change. Yeah, like we are all massive One Piece fans, right? Like me and Boom literally have our own solo channels, like dedicated to One Piece, pretty much. And, like my entire right arm from the top to my fucking fingertips is One Piece, like. We're big One Piece fans, but I legitimately like I like this more. I prefer the way they're telling the story here. I legitimately do. Like, I'm not exaggerating or like fucking, like, I'm dead serious.
I think it honestly depends on that, because like, since we have seen it in a more concise, quick manner, I think is like appealing to us that we're not having to go through 50 episodes to get these moments that we're getting like back to back to back.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like one of those that it is like, as a One Piece fan, I'm finding it to be like very satisfying. Now, don't get me wrong. Like, you know, we know a lot of One Piece fans like really, really enjoy the minutia of all that kind of stuff. And, you know, to an extent we do too. Like, that's the fun in talking about it. Right. But it's like, it's, I don't know, it's very satisfying to me that like, one, we're getting like things told in a different kind of order. Like I said, the pieces are all there in the world, like, and you can shift them to kind of like make the story you want.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm glad that they're doing that with this. But no, like I'm just enjoying that. Like, it feels like everything is like in a constant flow instead of like having those moments to where it's like, okay, we have to wait now for these things to happen. Mm-hmm. Like it's just been like constant gas.
It's like setting the stakes of the world, right? Like, we have the warlords have been revealed. We got Luffy's grandpa. We're learning about vice admirals. Like, we're getting to know a little bit about the world, learning that Garp, like, as somebody, doesn't want to move up because there's, you know, we could tell, oh, there's a little bit of, maybe we smell a little corruption up in that bitch. Like, all the breadcrumbs, like, they're just doing such a good job.
I think that's what's great. Like, they're setting the stage just by changing these pieces around, like Boom was saying.
Mm-hmm.
They're able to set the stage for something even more ominous, basically.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly.
Yeah. And like, we've already heard, like, because what, he talked about Baroque Works at one point, right?
Yeah.
Like, so we are aware of other things happening also in the world that are part of the world government, but aren't.
Well, there's a lot of stuff that Oda has been open about that he did not plan for, right? Like, I don't want to spoil anything, so I, you know, I guess just click the skip ahead 20 Earmuffs. Seconds button. Yeah, just skip ahead 20 seconds and you'll be golden. Like, Oda has said before, the warlords were it originally. Like, that was, he had no plans beyond that at all. I don't even think that the amount that was set in stone was set in stone. So, like, in that beginning, there was no plan for anything more ominous, because I think he only originally planned One Piece to be like 5 years or something. Like, it was a much shorter planned story. And, you know, knowing, like, now being able to go back and kind of retell that story with the knowledge and foresight of like what is to come.
Yep. And to have all the pieces ahead of you. To
I
know,
think it just it sets it up in a smoother transition that like will really hook people like from the start without you having to wait hundreds of episodes for like a big reveal that, you know, yes, is very impactful because, you know, it took that many episodes to get there. But,
well, I mean, we've talked about it too.
Still, it's the like same the impact, world, I feel.
Like, I think introducing, like, having that conversation with Garp and Mihawk, like, mm-hmm. that showed a new element that, like, we as, you know, fans of the show and manga haven't seen, right? Like, that was like, it was set up different. So like, the idea that they're already creating these things and like that excitement, like, among fans is going to push to, like, you know, to the normies and get them into the show and stuff like that. Like, it's going to be like this just permeating excitement, like, through everything that like has the ability. Cause like, people were talking about how they were worried that, like, is this, since they released all the episodes in one go, like, is everybody going to like forget it after like it's been out a month? But I think the stuff like this is what's going to be like carried, and like, depending how they end like the final episode, like, and trust me, we know Oda knows how to have a cliffhanger. I mean, there's a reason why "to be continued" is some people's worst nightmare. I think it's that kind of thing that, like, I'm not too worried about it. Like,
I'm not either.
Yeah,
I think it's almost a safe bet. Like, based on what I've been seeing comments wise, and lengthy discussion.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I have seen a very, like, split audience of, like, One Piece fans that are very unhappy with the live action. I don't personally get it, but, you know, everybody's, you know, entitled to their opinions. And then One Piece fans that are very happy with the adaptation. Mostly, it seems like manga fans pretty much unanimously are like, yeah, this is fucking great. And manga or anime fans seem to be on edge from what I can see, at least from, you know, comments I've seen. But I have not seen a negative comment from anybody that is new to One Piece. Anybody that has never seen One Piece that is now watching it for the first time, I have not seen a single negative comment. And that tells me they did a good job.
Yep. Yeah.
Starting to fit you after all.
Hmm.
And then they aim their biggest, baddest cannon.
They're all just watching him.
Billy, like, who is he talking to?
I'm the best shot. Down goes the yard. Marie's dead in the water.
Oh my God.
Oh.
Sir.
Oh.
You're the captain.
Well, who's about to get his ass beat?
I should very much like to meet this Luffy.
Uh-oh.
Sure.
Hey, be my new best friend. Would you say your name was?
No.
Which one of you is... Mihawk.
Oh. Oh, I can't wait for this.
With your captain. It's an honor to finally meet you, sir.
Thank you.
That's why it means me to inform you that tomorrow we're going to die.
Wait, what?
To the death.
Oh, and that music.
I'll take your captain.
Bro, I like him a lot.
He's so satisfying so far.
This starving pirate washed up earlier, and you know what Sanji did? He cooked for him right here in your kitchen because your rules matter less to him than making sure a hungry man got fed.
Ooh. Luffy, I don't think that's...
Well, good kid.
You are a fly to him. Something to be swatted and forgotten.
Not if I win.
You're not going to win.
You don't know that.
Guys, maybe we need more drinks.
He's like, if we're gonna die, let's at least get wasted.
If you fight him tomorrow, you're going to lose.
Why do you even give a shit?
Because you're my friend, you idiot.
Aww.
Oh, damn. Ooh. Damn.
Oh, but he's not wrong. I'm not gonna lie. If I was a pirate, I would do that a lot.
Puke?
Drink until I puke.
Oh, it looks so good.
I would pay an exorbitant amount of money to visit and see these things in person.
Yep.
Especially knowing that they're all real boats, like, it's just so crazy to think about. Oh, the tear.
Oh, I do like your hat.
Enough.
The hat.
Let's begin.
Oh, please say the best trash talk in the whole show.
What the hell is that? I'm here for a sword fight.
I don't hunt rabbits with a cannon.
Let's go. Oh, just, it's so good.
Literally.
And that's when he knew he fucked up.
I got you on a run, huh?
Hardly.
Oh my God.
You're strong. You're like a little frog croaking in a well. Croak, croak, croak.
God, I love that like they did that after, like, he was in the well and everything.
Oh.
She didn't go.
I need to retreat. I can't.
Oh.
Or my dream will be lost forever.
Stupid One Piece.
Getting chills, dude.
I'll give you that. So I'll do you the honor of killing you with Yoru.
Oh, I love that he named it too.
Oh man.
Oh.
I think you're right in that they're setting up Logue Town like real hard for like. Oh.
Magnificent.
I love him, dude. Oh my god. Oh. Oh, this is heartbreaking.
Oh my god.
Ugh. Ooh. God damn.
This world could use a few more wild cards. It's too soon for you to die.
Oh.
Grow strong and come find me. I'll be waiting.
God.
Damn, the acknowledgement there, though, too.
And denying Garp, too.
If I fail to become the world's greatest swordsman, you'll be disappointed, right?
You never fail me. I'll never lose again.
Oh my god.
Zoro?
God damn.
This was such an emotional moment.
Zoro!
Oh my god.
Wow.
It's just so good. Like every episode I've been blown away, bro. Like
yeah, Edith the Baratier, baby. Edith the Baratier.
I'm so curious how we're gonna wrap this up. I wonder if this next episode is gonna be partial Baratier, partial.
It's been feeling like two Arlong. Episodes. It's per arc, basically.
It does, but I mean, obviously, like Krieg is gone.
Remember. Was Nami actually part of that thing?
No.
She had left.
So Nami had already left in the show, and then
Usopp and all of them had left to find. No, that was later.
After Mihawk leaves, is when like the Krieg and Luffy fight happens.
Yeah,
but they're already dead.
But she left with their ship, though, right? With Luffy's ship, right?
She might.
So, like, that whole storyline's completely changed now because they still have a ship then.
Yeah, I mean, at least at the moment, yeah.
Wow.
I don't know how, like, that's what I'm like, I don't know how they're going to wrap up this arc, at least in a full episode. So, like, I feel like there's a possibility that this arc and the next might blend in this final one because we have five, right? We have three left. So if we did assume the Baratie took up a whole two arcs and then Arlong took up a whole two arcs, that would mean we wouldn't get Logue Town. But I feel like we're gonna get Logue Town. I don't know why. Like, based on what they've shown, like, I would be shocked if we didn't see Logue Town in this.
I just feel like that's gonna be like the finale almost. The way
right? That's what it
up,
feels like. It has
I'm
to
not
be.
Sure.
We'll find out. If you don't want to wait for the videos, come to Patreon, get it early, uncut, all that jazz. And we're going to go watch some more.
Yes, sir. Off to the binge.
Bye.
Bye.
Be the joy.